All right, we have a special little recording here. We're going to talk about a very quick one. I'm going to talk about the organization of the Hans Weir Dictionary. Now, I know all of you love your Hans Weir Dictionary. You say, this thing is fabulous. I am so excited about tabbing this and using it, but I have some questions about how it is organized. Well, aren't you lucky? Today, we're going to talk about how to find the words in the Hans Weir Dictionary, basically the organization of the words. Now, you've had other lessons on how to find individual words, but how are they, what order do they come in? That's what we're going to talk about today. Now, as you know, Hans organizes his words by root. And here's a page fresh out of the Hans Weir Dictionary, and you can see all the words having to deal with kataba from this root. Up at the top, here's our three-letter root. And if you flip through the entire book, you'll see on every page there is the three-letter root. So, okay, we know he organizes them by three-letter root. And we know those are organized alphabetically by the first letter, then the second letter, then the third letter. Okay, great. So this is wonderful. So you should, I mean, assuming you know the order of the alphabet, you should be fine. If you don't, go listen to the song on YouTube and it will just stick in your head forever. The issue is there are some letters that are a little bit problematic. And they're really not a big deal, but we're going to talk about them today. We're going to show you what they are, and so this way you'll know the order to look up words. So there's a couple of situations. The first one we want to deal with is doubled letters. For example, you all know that this word here, jadid, comes from the root jim dal dal. Okay, the last two letters are the same. Now, in just for your knowledge, it will always be the last two letters that are the same, never the first two. Now, I mean, if the first and the third one are the same, that's no problem whatsoever, of course. But it's the last two that are doubled. And the reason for this, just in case you're interested, is we know Arabic has a three-letter root system, but as the language was growing, it absorbed words from other Semitic languages that had a two-letter root system. So a word like jadid originally would have had a two-letter root. What they did is they doubled the last letter. Anyway, that's just trivia, where it comes from. The question, though, is where would Hans put this root? Well, you may say, oh, I know my alphabet. So if I'm looking, these are all real roots that appear in the Hans Weir dictionary, you say it should fit right there. Okay, jim, they're all jims. Then dal, we know dal comes after ba. Okay, and this dal should come after that ba. That is a perfectly logical conclusion. It just happens to be wrong, at least in terms of Hans. Now you have to understand, Hans is kind of a purist. So remember what he shows, and this is the logic behind it. Okay, he's showing this three-letter root, and we call this the dictionary form or the infinitive. But remember what that actually is. What is kataba actually? It means he wrote, right? We don't have any infinitive, so it means he wrote. So he shows the third person past tense form of this root. Well, that's no issue, except, okay, what is the third person past tense of this root? Well, it's that. It becomes a shadda. So anyway, the point is, just remember that when you have this, anytime the last two letters are the same, Hans is going to make a shadda out of them. Put them together and make a shadda. Oh, you say, well, that's no problem. It should still go there. No, actually, the way Hans looks at it, okay, yeah, he does go alphabetically, but first he goes by the number of letters. So a two-letter root is going to beat three-letter roots that start with the same letter. So it would go here, because, of course, ba, b, comes before this dal, d. But this two-letter root, he's basically saying nothing, a blank here comes before that. Anyway, you don't have to like it. You don't really even have to understand what he's thinking. Just know that this would go at the beginning of this set of letters. You look up for everything else like that. Great, you say, this is fabulous. Okay. Well, as you might expect, the most problematic letters in Arabic are the long vowels. I mean, this is kind of like the big tough guy who's not afraid of anything, but then he sees a mouse and he jumps screaming up on his chair. Well, this is like this. So anytime an Arabic speaker wants to tell you how, oh, our language is perfectly logical and systematic, just mention long vowels. They see a long vowel, they go into an absolute panic, and for everything, you know that. So these are going to be our three troublemakers. Okay. And one of the problems about long vowels is they disappear. Another problem is they switch from one to another. Now, as the course goes on, you'll understand more about how they switch. But an aleph can turn into a wow, an aleph can turn into a yeah, and based on a lot of reasons, and we'll learn some of them. So let's try to make this simple. The first thing is aleph is never part of a root. The vowel aleph is never part of a root. Now you say, oh, I flip through the dictionary and I see a lot of words with it in there. Yeah, but it's not actually part one of the root letters. So don't look there. No, that only leaves us with two. Okay, so let's take an example. Here are a whole bunch of words. All right, now you see these all have the long vowel aleph in it. Well, what you need to know is the roots of these words are the following. And now here's just a good rule of thumb. Wow is far more common in roots than yeah is. So if you have to guess, guess with the wow. And then we do that a lot. We end up looking up the word under both and see which one we find it. Okay, but these are the actual roots of these words. This is where you would look them up. Okay, so if I wanted to look up those words, well, I know my order. Now here's the point. I want to look up a word. Let's say a word like nama, to sleep. Lovely word. We want to look it up. Okay, we go to noon. Then we say, oh, aleph. Aleph is the first letter of the alphabet. Yeah, but aleph is not the root letter. The root letter is wow. The root letter is always going to be a wow or a yeah. These are your two choices. Well, where do they occur? They occur at the very end of the alphabet, meaning this word or this word is going to be at the end of the noon section. This word is going to be at the end of the cough section, and so forth. Got it? That's where to look for it. You'll find it. So, nama, for example, would appear like here. Aft, not before. You say, oh, aleph comes before ba. Oh, great. Yeah, except that's not, it's not an aleph. The root letter is a wow. So, no, it comes after the ba, after the meem, after the ha. The only thing it'll come before is this yeah. Okay? Great. Got it? Absolutely. Of course you do. This is an actual picture of the Hans-Werder dictionary, tabbed, as you see, as it should be. Notice the alternating colors on the tabs. This is a good help. That's something you should do. Okay, but here it is. Here is this verb. Yeah, I mean, you realize you can barely see it. Here's the verb nama, right there. Where does it appear? It appears under this section. He goes with, on the right-hand side, he goes with the last root. On the left-hand pages, he goes with the first one. But anyway, it's under this root noun, and he gives you the root in parentheses, but puts the verb form here. Okay, it's going to be the same thing with all the others. There you go. Got it? Wunderbar. Okay. Oh, just one other thing to tell you. Now, you, if the letter is in the middle, it's going to look like this, no problem. Sometimes we have an aleph, and sometimes we have the aleph maksura. Well, you might say, why do we have these? Why do we even have aleph maksura in the first place? Aleph maksura, the reason it exists is to tell you that the root letter is a ya. That's the only difference between these two. They are pronounced exactly the same. So this one has a root letter of a wow. How do you know it? Because it's got a regular aleph. This one has a root letter of a ya. How do you know? Because it's got an aleph maksura. That's what aleph maksura means. That's the only point that it has. That's what it appears. Okay? So you're going to look for this word under ra mim ya. Okay, that's pretty straightforward. Got it? Oh man, great. Okay. All right, we have only one last problematic letter, and that is Hamza. Now you're saying, wait a minute, Hamza is not a letter. Dude, I know my alphabet. Hamza was not in the song. Okay. Arabic does not consider Hamza to be a letter. This is why we tell you, oh, you only have to learn 28 letters, and we sneak this extra one in. But it really is a letter, and one of the reasons is Hamza can be in a root, and Hamza, when it's in a root, is just like any other letter. As you know, Hamza can sit on a whole lot of seats, or it can be by itself. Okay, so here is the thing to understand. Hans, in terms of putting this alphabetically, okay, there's no place for Hamza in the alphabet. So what Hans does, not that, he doesn't do that. What Hans does is he goes with Aleph. Okay, so you may have, I told you there's no Aleph in a root, but you say, wait a minute, there's a whole Aleph section in my Hans Ver dictionary. I know because I tabbed it, and that was the first tab that I put in. Yeah. All those words, by the way. Okay, they are all have a Hamza on them. So what Hans does is, even though they come on all these different seats, Hans lists Hamza as a root letter. He lists it with Aleph. Now you're saying that's a little bit confusing. Okay, so let's give you some examples. These are all real words, real roots, actually, that have a hamsa in them. Now, really, remember the seat doesn't mean anything. Like the root akala to eat. Ooh, what a great word! Akala, the root is hamsa, kaf, lam, and because depending on the word, the seat will change. Beda'a to begin, the root is ba, dal, hamsa, and so forth. Hans will list them like this, but in terms of where he puts them in the order of his dictionary, and that's all we're talking about, remember, is the order of the dictionary. He puts them with other alephs. Now you said to me, wait just a minute, ya Habibi. You told me aleph is never a root letter. Very true, but remember, there's also a lot of foreign words that will have aleph in them. Okay, so they're. You're going to have that. And we'll show you some examples of it. So, where would you look up Akala? You would look this up under the A section of your dictionary. Okay? All right, now we want to try a little exercise here. You will love this. This could be a fabulous party game. All right, so here we have a list of words. These are all real entries, headings in the Hans Ver dictionary, meaning all the headings in the Hans Ver dictionary are either an Arabic root or they're a foreign word. I mean, foreign words are just like California or something. They're just listed by their spelling. Okay, these are all real entries in the Hans Ver dictionary. However, they are not in the correct order. So we want you to put them in the correct order that Hans would show them. Now, one thing I would just tell you could probably guess, there is one foreign word in this list. Which one is it? Yeah, the one that's got too many long vowels. Baba. Baba means Pope. Baba Francis. That's the only one that is a foreign word. The rest are all standard Arabic roots. So, we are going to give you a minute here to figure out what order to put these in, and then we'll check it. All right, you got it? Well, if you don't, we're going to move on anyway. Okay, hopefully you came up with this order, which is the order that these appear in the Hans Ver dictionary. And so if you have that, you should be good. Okay, why? No, remember this word here, the root is ba hamza ra. It means to dig a well. Okay, but remember, Hans lists these as an aleph. Okay. So this aleph, even though it's the root letter is a hamsa, is going to go just with the others. These aleph's are really alephs because this is a foreign word. So baba will come before ba'er only because this ba alphabetically comes before this ra. So a word like basu is a foreign word, would come after this, okay, because the scene is empty. So anyway, just treat these as normal alephs, but remember, it's the hamsa is the root letter. Okay, then obviously badr, because the dal comes after the aleph or the hamsa. Okay, then obviously it should be this word because of the noon. Now this one, bata, notice this has an aleph, but it comes at the end. This has an aleph, but it comes at the beginning. Why? Because the root letter, remember this is an Arabic root, the root letter is not aleph, the root letter in this case is ya. And you might note that bata means to like stay overnight. It's the same root from which we get bait, and so it's related to that. Okay, that's the rules. That's where to look up for these words. So if you're not sure, if you look up at the beginning for an aleph, if you look at the beginning of the entries, you'll find out if it's a foreign word. If you find it at the end, you know it's an Arabic root. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. We need a dog before we can close this out. Hold on. Pause. Okay. We're back. Ooh, Rusty. It's our good friend Rusty. He wishes you all the best with your adventures with the Hans Ver Dictionary. Shukran, Jazilan. Thank you.